I'm expecting kind of like a bit of weirdness, and this already looks like a scene straight up from Alien, so don't know how this is gonna go, guys. Oh, was that Lisa? No, that's Jenny. Oh my god, she did really, really well there. That's a great opener. That Jisoo? That does not sound like Jisoo. Is that Jisoo? Jenny's voice is super well suited for this song. I'm really, really liking it so far. We got a lot of Blackpink. Who is that? Jisoo? Yeah, it's Jisoo. Oh, Jisoo! With the like, oh, like that, like the raspiness. Oh! So clearly, sour candy is a metaphor for something else, but you know, it's being expected with Lady Gaga. You would honestly think that this is a Blackpink song featuring Lady Gaga. Open. And you all say, "Oh, Yoda Boo and Tony." Hello, everyone. It's Tony. So they are finally back. The girls of Blackpink are, I guess you would say, sort of finally back. They have actually released today, a bit earlier than expected, their collaboration with Lady Gaga on her Chromatica upcoming album that's supposed to be released tomorrow, actually. So it was a big surprise that their track got released today. Their track is titled Sour Candy, so it's by Lady Gaga featuring the girls of Blackpink. If you aren't already aware, it's actually the number one top trending K-pop girl group song on iTunes, with the no most number ones on iTunes app history for K-pop girl groups. So already these girls are breaking records, and I think after the first hour, the video had over 11 million views. Absolutely insane things that these K-pop girls are doing right now. Just unbelievable what they're achieving in just not even just the world of K-pop, but like just breaking barriers. Absolutely insane. I'm super excited to listen into this. It's also maybe going to give us a bit of a look into what their upcoming comeback is in June. Well, pre-comeback, because they're doing it in steps. I think their actual official comeback is sometime in September. So I'm super excited, guys. Let's get into it. Without further ado, Junbi, ready? She check. Oh. Okay, a bit like robotic. So this has actually been a while since I last listened to like Mother Monster, so it's gonna be interesting to hear her sound too. But in general, I'm expecting kind of like a bit of weirdness, and this already looks like a scene straight up from Alien, so don't know how this is gonna go, guys. Oh, was that Lisa? That Jenny? No, it's. No, that's Jenny. Oh my god, she did really, really well there. That's a great opener. Okay, now it's Lisa? Okay, that's Rosé. Okay, there's the Korean. That Jisoo? That does not sound like Jisoo. Is that Jisoo? God, the beat's so cool though. That's Jenny. Jenny's voice is super well suited for this song, actually. I find it's super kind of like sensual, just really clean, smooth. Really, really liking it so far. We got a lot of Blackpink. Who is that? Jisoo? Yeah, it's Jisoo. Oh, Jisoo! With the like, oh, like that, like the raspiness. Oh! Okay, so here's Mother Monster. That's actually very interesting. Right now, the way I hear it, you would think that this is actually a Blackpink song featuring Lady Gaga, because how she's coming across right now, it sounds almost that she's taking a step back and letting the girls of Blackpink be more of the focal spotlight. Because you kind of like her voice and how she's approaching the singing part almost sounds as if she wants to be a not a lead character, but kind of like an extra. It just sounds like, you know, it's like that part that you would normally give to the person featured. It's like the slow, not as like intense and explosive in your face type of thing, which is why I'm also surprised that she didn't do the first verse. I thought they were gonna do like something in the middle. Okay. I was honestly expecting a drop. So clearly sour candy is a metaphor for something else, but you know, it's being expected with Lady Gaga. Let's keep on going. I wonder if Blackpink comes back. I'd be very interested if they came back or like harmonize with her. I just realized my volume's really high. Oh, it's Rosé! Lisa! So far, I think of all the Blackpink members, the two that fit the song the most in terms of like how they're coming about the song, I think, and how their voice fits, I would actually have to say Jisoo and Jennie. Jisoo, like, it's a very big surprise for me because you would think that Jisoo wouldn't actually fit this song too well, but she's actually doing quite well, especially with how she her vocalizing of like in her transitions, really nice and very smooth and crispy clean. And Jennie just has that swagger about her. I would say the same about Lisa. I definitely put Lisa above Rosé. I think Rosé's a bit not out of her depth, but like this song doesn't fit her too well. Take a bite. Sour candy. Wow, it's already over. Holy cow. So that was Blackpink. Well, sorry, Lady Gaga. See, this is how easy it is for me to confuse it because of the opening. So you have Lady Gaga featuring Blackpink, Sour Candy. I'm extremely surprised at how this song was formatted because I was expecting, for one, Blackpink to be taking a step back and being kind of the supporting role, but almost from the way this song is put together, you would honestly think that this is a Blackpink song featuring Lady Gaga. Opening, and for most of it, I feel like, is Blackpink. And then only like in a few portions do you have Lady Gaga, and she's doing mainly like a chorus, but like a very like pulled back, very simple chorus that I feel like is kind of just under the radar and not very in your face. Whereas like, I feel like Blackpink has all of like the pop out moments and the very standout moments. So I'm very surprised at how they went about making this song. I'm pleasantly surprised, obviously, because I love Blackpink, but still I'm very surprised that there wasn't more of like the like bound, like the craziness that Lady Gaga's known for. Like obviously the beat's a bit different, a bit techno, a bit outside of Blackpink's realm, but still I was expecting a bit more like, you know, just like I don't know, something like that. Overall, I think they really, really did well. I'm really excited because the vocals that I hear from Blackpink in this song, very different from what you hear from like Kill This Love, which was their most recent EP. Even Square Up, I believe it was called. Yeah, Square Up. I think this is actually very different also. Like this is just different in general. Like Jisoo's voice sounds so much different. Rosé's voice sounds so much different. Jennie's voice actually sounds a lot more like swaggery-ish. Like if that's not a word, obviously, but like it has a lot more like just confidence, I find, and like just more swagger and like oomph to her like sound. And then Lisa, obviously, always like the confidence and everything. So I think all four of them really have kind of like evolved in their vocals, and I'm super excited now hearing this as like a mini teaser for their upcoming songs, because if this is like kind of a teaser of like what at least the vocals are about to be like, this is going to be an amazing comeback by Blackpink. With regards to obviously Lady Gaga, hats off to her for kind of like taking a supporting role in my opinion, because it takes a lot to be able to still have such a presence with doing so little. Like her choruses, her voice wasn't super pronounced in comparison to Blackpink. She really just said like the chorus, Unwrap Me, Sour Candy type of stuff like that, but she still had a huge part, and I think that having her come into the song also really breaks up everything, so it really makes everything stand out a bit more. But with that, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this reaction. I apologize for it being so late, but thank you. I hope you guys enjoyed. Gamsamnida. And as always, if you have any comments, questions, or if you want to leave any thing to talk about, feel free to leave them a comment section below, and I'll get back to them as soon as possible. But yeah, with that, guys, hopefully you enjoyed. And until next time, 안녕히 계세요. Goodbye.